Hey guys, it's me again. Can you believe this? I'm shooting 3 videos in one day. By the way, I am, one of the things that I take every day, first of all, this is my, let's see if I can show you. These are all of the herbs and vitamins and supplements that I take every day. I'm not taking anything like fat burners or weird stuff like that. But I've done so much research, over the past, this is that emergency stuff. Vitamin C. I have 2,000 milligrams of vitamin C every day. And in case you're wondering how, my counter's dirty. In case you're wondering how I figure out, you know, like, do I just randomly take stuff? No, this, and I'm adding actually a few things. In fact, let me see if I've got it over here. Hold on one second. But some of these things, I'm actually talking to my new guru, Kevin, health guru, spirit guide, Kevin. So I was having some serious, for the first time in my life, major business pressure and changes and crazy stuff going on. And for the first time in my life, I was having, excuse me, major trouble sleeping, but it was really anxiety related. At first I thought, oh, my hormones have gotten, you know, off balance. We've been doing some tweaking with testosterone for me, but I was attributing it to that when really it was anxiety. I had that feeling of kind of breathlessness and I couldn't sleep as a result. So one of the things I started taking at night is GABA. And this is from my friend Kevin, who you will get to meet in other formats. I'll explain how you're going to meet him and learn from him. He's teaching me so much. This is a guy who went to the doctor 4 or 5 years ago. I met him online on Twitter years ago. He went to the doctor and his doctor was like, and he wasn't really like hugely overweight. I think he was only 10 pounds heavier than he is now. But his doctor was like, you know, based on your cholesterol, based on all this other stuff, you know, you're 2 seconds away from diabetes. You're, you know, you need to get a grip on your health. You've got major heart problems, all this stuff. So he went really serious and made some lifestyle changes, got into CrossFit back then. I don't believe he does CrossFit now. He does his own style of training. Went into a paleo lifestyle, cut out all of the fake crap, a lot of the stuff that I was having too, you know, the bars, the protein shakes, the, you know, just lifestyle, eating a lot of packaged foods with stuff you don't even know about it. And I used to joke about that stuff. But he transformed and he's, you know, I've always seen him on Facebook and been like, damn, boy. Well, then his girlfriend, and I don't know, they might have gotten married, so I don't know if it's girlfriend or wife, forgive me. His girlfriend, she was having major issues with her, you know, just body changing. And I believe, I could be wrong, she had gone through menopause, early menopause. But ultimately, he started going to the doctor with her. What the doctors were telling her was very similar to what doctors tell a lot of women, which is, you know, you're depressed. Let me give you some antibiotics, you know, blah, blah, blah. Some of them want to give you antidepressants. But they're just trying to treat random symptoms as opposed to getting you fixed as a person and getting you balanced as a person and healthy as a person, everything, how everything's all connected. Kevin started doing a lot of research, and that's when he started learning all of this madness that comes with hormonal imbalance and happiness and awesomeness that comes with hormonal balance. So he worked with her. She has a wonderful transformational story. I mean, you can see her before and after, and it's like a new woman who looks like she's, you know, 10, 20 years younger because of feeling, you know, just healthy, happy, and full of energy and drive and passion when you have your hormones balanced. But he is my, I call him my spirit guide now, because he's taught me so much. He connected with me and said, so glad you're doing the bioidentical treatment. That's going to change your life. And I remember when he said that in the beginning, I'm thinking, well, he must know somebody that's gone through this. But then we connected, we did a phone call, and I started telling him about my hypothyroidism and my insulin resistance. And then he said, you know, he started talking to me about iodine and supplementing with iodine. And that's one of the things that I do in the morning. I'll do other videos on this stuff, trying to be very focused, even though now as I'm thinking of these first 3 videos I've shot, they have been my typical ramble-on-a-thons. There's a weird guy out walking his dog in my backyard. Can't wait to move. By the way, for those of you that don't know this, I'm moving to Arizona as soon as possible. No, I'm not moving to Miami. I changed my mind. It's been a lot of life changes here. Who is that guy? Stop looking in here. Anyway, one of the things that Kevin told me was, you know, iodine is such a serious issue for hypothyroidism. So I supplement with, it's called Soleil. I call it Soleil. You might call it Sol. But if you Google pink Himalayan sea salt and then the word S-O-L-E, I say Soleil. I don't know why. It might be Sol. Who cares? I take this pink Himalayan sea salt mix in water every morning with my bulletproof coffee. And then he told me like the next level up of iodine sublimation is this. So I have not yet started using this because I need him to teach me how much to use and whatever. And then in some of my other books, so that I knew what to be taking and in what amounts, basically what I did is I started researching first insulin resistance. And what causes it, what foods I needed to cut. Then I started researching hypothyroidism. And as I started pulling together, I realized there was so much information that I was pulling together from so many different resources. And this is why I'm creating an ebook on it, because I'm just gonna tell you, if you go to research this stuff, you'll spend hours and months, and I mean just forever, weeks and months and months and months and months of research, because there's not just like a bestseller on Amazon that's like, here's everything you need to know. I mean, there's some, but each book will make you end up doing more research. And then again, you'll meet somebody like Kevin, or you'll find a doctor like my doctor, and then you start doing more research and learning more. And I've just pulled together this massive amount of research. And for me, you know, I'm addressing hormonal imbalance, hypothyroidism, and insulin resistance. And then potentially this other autoimmune disease that has to do with, you know, these weird skin bumps I get when my hormones are out of whack. So as Valerie Waters said to me when she was here, standing in my kitchen, watching me eat organic Eglin's Best eggs and Ezekiel bread, she's like, Kelly, you've got the card stacked against you. You know, you can attack it, but it's going to be, basically, you know, I came to the realization that everything I want to accomplish with getting healthier and fit, you know, it's 10 times harder for me than any other person. You know, I can't just work out and eat healthy. I have to do all of these things, but I got to tell you, implementing the dietary changes, the lifestyle changes, making sure I get my vitamins and my supplements every day, making sure I get enough sunshine, making sure I'm getting the vitamin D that's critical, making sure I'm getting healthy sleep, and paying attention to, now I'm starting to learn about their circadian cycles and all of that, it adds up. I mean, I turned 47 in a week, 2 weeks, is it a week, I think, and I feel better about myself. My health, my body, my mind, my energy, my future, than I certainly did at age 40. And that's, you know, that was really the beginning. It was probably age 39 when things started to go haywire for me, and that's when my hormones started going crazy. But I have to tell you, doing your research and finding out, you know, here's a very simple thing. If you have hypothyroidism, everyone should be taking selenium once a day. So that's one of the things that's in there. I know I've also got evening primrose oil. I've got some zinc. That's for your skin as well. And some of these things too. It's what's interesting is, you know, I find out something that was good for skin conditions as I was studying the weird, you know, bumps that I get on my neck and my back, upper back. So some of the things were for skin, but then I realized, oh, well, zinc is also good for, you know, for this situation, and oh, magnesium is good for sleep, but it's also good for anxiety, it's also good for this. So then what I would do is compare all of these things, write down the research, write down what it was good for, look at the dosage, and that's how I figured it out. Because people, you know, it is confusing. You can go to a vitamin shop and find something that has a 50 milligram serving, 100 milligram serving, 1,000 milligram serving, and yes, you can go overboard. You know, you don't want to be having 10,000 milligrams of vitamin C. I do 2,000 every day. I've researched all this stuff, and then I made the decision on how much. And I always ran everything by my doctor. So pay attention. Details count. They add up. Lifestyle changes add up. And stay the course. That's all I have to tell you is, you know, I said this in my last video. I was talking about the importance of eating enough, eating the right foods, take care of yourself instead of, I think the biggest, one of the biggest attitude changes I've had over the last 9 to 10 months is instead of looking at punishing myself and going, oh, I'm not allowed to have this, I'm not allowed to have this, you've been so bad, you haven't lost weight. I'm like, this is what I'm doing for my body, to treat my body and this vessel I've been given by God is in the best possible way that I can. Let me fuel my body. Let me make sure that when I have a great workout, I'm giving myself back, you know, the fuel and the energy that my body needs, and instead of punishing myself. And it's all worked together to create a much different present for me, and certainly a much different future. So lastly, let me wrap up, and I will do more detailed videos on all of this stuff later. I just happened to throw up my tripod this morning, and I wanted to do this post-workout, but I do have to run. So two things. Because everybody's asking me, and you'll notice that I'm starting to wear different things, but everybody always asks me about my hats. They always ask me about my tops. So two things. I get these funny hats at Walmart. So go to your local Walmart, ladies. They are in they are in just the hat section up by the jewelry. Sports bras. I have to say, ladies, if you have this going on, Victoria's Secret has the best sports bras, bar none, more than anybody else. I used to love Under Armour. What I didn't love about Under Armour is all they had was black and white for that, and it was just boring. Victoria's Secret has bras that hold your girls up, but they have fun colors, because let's get real. Most tops are gonna show your sports bra no matter what you do. They're gonna show it in the back, they're gonna show it in the front. So for me, I didn't want just white and black from Under Armour. So that's what I love. This top is from Hylete. Hylete, I've known these guys since they founded the company. Matt, the founder, is a friend of mine. And I met them about 4 years ago. Now, when they first came out, they had probably 70% of their clothes were for men, and they had some for women. They didn't have as many of the clothes for women, and I always would look at the men's clothes. And I gotta tell you, men, if you're watching this, go to Hylete.com. They have, I mean, their apparel for men, it just looks amazing. Anybody that I know that's bought Hylete becomes obsessed with them, and the clothes make a man, they just fit men really well. Now they've really expanded and they have women's lines, so you'll see me wearing more of them. I would never have thought I would like, this is a very thin fabric. This is one of their new tops. If you head on over there now, there's also a C3 challenge you're gonna see me being a part of. You can sign up for that and get a $25 gift card. Only the first 5,000 people though that sign up for the challenge. This charity challenge, which I'm gonna do too. But this is really thin and it's blousy, and I just love the way, if you follow me on Instagram and on my blog, you'll see, you know, better pictures. I just love their stuff. They have great hoodies. They've got fantastic leggings. It's just a nice look. So, and also they have a wonderful, wonderful client referral program. So I'll put the links below, but I encourage you, men and women, to go check them out. Great friend of mine, they sent me some wonderful clothes and I am pleasantly surprised and really loving it. And now throwing away all of my old comfort zone workout clothes that I used to kind of hide in, you know? And now it's like, stand proud, love who you are, be proud of it, and wear some fashionable, fun clothes. I gotta go, it's 13 minutes. I will see you very soon.